can and sort of should a company be looking to measure results from these types of programs? And if they should, do you have any metrics in mind they could look at?
Well, like I said before, so let me start off actually with your question of should they? I think anytime you're doing any type of investment, you do want to know what your return on investment is. Mm-hmm. The thing with wellness programs is that there is still a lot of intangible results that are shown that you couldn't necessarily have a baseline to begin with. I mean, a lot of wellness programs actually just bring about a culture shift. And so were you less trusting? And how did you gauge that first and foremost? I will say that those organizations that do invest in wellness, it's almost a feeling you get when you walk in. And again, because for really good wellness programs, holistic wellness programs to be working, trust and transparency is there. You do see it. You do sense it.
Yeah.
But things like, you know, certainly things like how often are your benefits, your group health and dental benefits, are the costs rising? What were they before you started your wellness program and what are they afterwards?
Yeah.
And I think it's twofold too. Sometimes with health and dental benefits, you know, people don't really want to tell you what it is that are in your plan, so you don't use it, which I think is the complete opposite reason of having a health and dental plan.
Yeah.
But knowing where, you can certainly look at where they're using things, and are they using more proactive things? Like, I would love to see my drug costs go down and my massage and chiro go up because people are being proactive with their health.
Yeah, absolutely.
So those are things that you can start to look at. Then, of course, like we said, the sick days, you know, do they start to drop? Mm-hmm. But instead of looking in as less sick days, again, planned.
Yes.
Those days that are planned sick days.
Yeah.
I know for myself, I have a team member that I have to push getting her to take vacation time off. She has to go. It's one of her goals that I make her take 1 week every quarter off. And I have to push her to do it because if she does, she gets really silly when she doesn't take that time away for herself.
Yeah.
And so even looking at your vacation and having people plan out their vacation in advance and taking that time off, mm-hmm. So you can look at productivity before and after those certain things.
I imagine retention too.
Retention is just, I mean, it's more than a wellness program, but it certainly could be one of the factors. Again, mm-hmm. that's one of the intangible results because you can't say that it's totally tied to wellness, but those are all analytics that you can be looking at that certainly support the need for wellness, and then even your engagement results. So if you're doing annual engagement surveys, you could even ask questions there before, post, you know, pre and post your wellness program to measure, hey, is this something that you actually like? Mm-hmm. And do you see a benefit in this?
Yeah,